Let's not go there for failure. Alright, so last night you were covered attacking Mace. Attacking Sacrifice, rather. So specifically, the first kind of intro to it is your inward block followed by your punch. Now last week we covered a variant of that, where we hit this, we pull through. This time we're very direct, hitting straight in on that line. So there's a slightly weaker configuration in the sense that your wrist has a lot more play in it. Here it's a lot stronger, unless you do something really weird at the end of it. So what we're going to look at is this kind of horizontal punch for tonight, reverse punch in this case. To bring it back to the simplest terms, when we're working on pads, we go jab cross, when we close we go jab cross, it is essentially a cross. The only difference is, because the time is high, we aim for the low line, but it is essentially jab cross every time. Okay? So how do we get here? We'll build the technique into these because, yes, the punch is the important part, so please focus on that. But obviously then I won't have you drilling for an hour just doing punches to the ribs, because that's going to get annoying. Okay, we hit. This is going to come from the chest for now, around about the pec level. Palm's going to face up as I hit through. It's going to turn at the last second. As usual, we close. Finger to thumb, pinky to thumb. We're getting that good shot in, okay? Stance, forward blow coming through. Keeping the other hand up as a cover no matter what. Obviously then, as we covered last night, you can have your kick through, you can have your throw, you can have whatever you want from there. Okay? Attacking Sacrifice specifically working from this position. So what we want to do is, since you've done Attacking Sacrifice, work from that position for now. Get to here and go through the technique, that way we keep repping it. But the important focus for here is to generate the power of this, and to make sure that you're causing an effect. Alright? Or having an effect, right? Alright? Okay, cool. So, the thing is, as I've already said, the punch is important, but as you'll notice, I don't have to power through someone to make them move. If I have to do that, then realistically I don't have a technique, I just have brute force movements. Which is a technique in its own right, that's not joking about. But if I want to make an effect on Brent, maybe I don't want to cave his ribs in, because maybe I don't want to go to prison. Maybe I just want to do something to push him away a little bit, okay? So that's important. So, like last week we said, when we move the person, they're coming forward, then I hit him, then I move. So, I'm kind of extending his ribs, I'm making sure he's still coming forward, that there's still some mobility in him, which makes it easier for me to take that out of him. So on this one, I've done a definite stop here. Then as I fire, it's not usually to hit a little harder or badly, Brent goes right back. I hit a little lighter, but better, goes away very quickly.
Sorry, can I see that one more time, please?
Of course. Want to volunteer? So, the point is, what we're adding here is a rotation of the wrist. It's not me just punching from here like this, there's nothing going into it. So when I turn, that's me hitting in, and you'll see that kind of position there, from palm up to palm down. Okay? So when we hit, that's all we really need. When we drive all our power into it, then we have a much deeper and stronger technique. Okay? That makes sense. So, the important part, as I said, finish the technique, but look for the focus of make that punch better. That doesn't mean power through the guy and take his ribs out or his spine out through the front of his body. That means hit him and move. Make sure he moves. Okay? Alright. So, to add another one to the mix, we already have Attacking Sacrifice. There's no point in going any further with that one for now. It's a good technique and it works and it covers more than last night. This is just an extra slant on it. Okay? Next one, from another straight punch for now, I'm going to take this slightly off angle, so I'm not maybe going to have the opportunity to step forward and block with my other hand from far away. I'm going to have to move up. Okay? So maybe I get flanked, maybe I get short-changed, and I get caught up out here. Same position, as I step through, rotate through. The difficulty here is, this is now your close hand, not your back hand, but you still should be able to generate the punch. Now, maybe the back hand, depending on how I turn, but essentially, it's close enough that it's not going to be as easy as this. So when I hit, I'm going to need that rotation. I'm also not flaring the elbow, so I'm not going this way. It stays tight to the body, shoots out with his back. Okay? You got this? So, again, comes off the side, step forward with the left. Okay? So you are stepping with the opposite hand, but you're blocking or with the step into the opposite foot and blocking with the right hand in this case, or vice versa depending on time. So when we hit from here, rotate through, punch. Okay, and you guys are a little bit more advanced than we were at the beginning, so we'll need more. So from this point, when we hit this, the next thing we're going to do is drop a hammer straight down. So as I hit this, I'm going to drop. Okay, as I drop, that's going to cause the action brain, which is that. Okay, so we hit one, we drop to here. From here, for now, we'll make it nice and easy. Now you practice your back right fold. Okay, so. As we step forward again, we're taking it in, coming up, push through, drop, shoot up to here, elbow down. From here, kick, kick down. At this point, we all know we have options. We take from here, we do all these that we already have, and so on and so forth. Get to next stuff, and so on and so forth. So I will leave that bit up to you to practice your straight arm locks at the end. Use the variable or the variables that we've given you already at this point. The important part is to get that punch in as well. So you step, punch through, drop, shoot, pull. From here, kick, take him down. From this, sweep. Up we go. In previous weeks, we talked about this kind of idea of once I land the hand on, there's a level of friction that's there. I don't kind of disengage to re-engage. Some of the time, I'll hit through, engage, use this to start with a little or move them a little bit, and then flow somewhere else. So a lot of the time, we'll use it on these particular elbows. So when I check, I pull them in from here. Instead of kind of going, I'll just flap and pull. Okay, so this will pull, this will then drive out, hit the face, generate short power, okay? So similar concept in this. When we move forward on this line, we pick this up from here, this is gonna drop, this is gonna check down this time. Just gonna move this, okay? You can do this without that, and just come straight back up to here. I just like the extra effect when you're advancing it. Make sure that head comes forward and it makes it much easier to control because he's falling forward and he wants to get back on balance. So at this point, you're going to get him back on balance. Here's where that friction maybe comes in, okay? So I've got this. So rather than going and letting him reset the base and maybe stagger away or whatever else, at this point, once I'm here, take him over and then from here, drop. Hit that line out. What you're hitting is the leg. But there should be no weight on that leg, because if there's weight on that leg, he's just going to be pissed off. So when you break him from here, he's off that leg for the most part. So when you hit and he's basically being driven towards the floor, that's the position you're looking for. Okay? Much like the reaps, much like that, you need to break that balance, you need to take him off and ensure that that leg moves easily. If that leg is down and weighted, it's not going to work, okay? So we're just playing with another concept here as well, as we play. But again, like I said, to stress the importance, none of that will work if this doesn't work. Because I can stand here and do this to him all day, and nothing happens. If I move in and I just flip, I might get a reaction, maybe not. If I move, that's where we start getting actions. There's not much going into them, there's just technique, okay? That's important. So make sure, like we've said for the previous weeks, you have to generate a movement from them. Get them to a point of off balance, then generate your throw. You know, this is the position. If there's a problem with the throw, one step beforehand is where you want to be. My throw is not working from here. It's not because my throw is wrong. It's because the step that got me there is wrong. Okay? Good with that? All right. Add that little tweak in. So you hit through, drop, pin, pull. From here, as I pull, make sure that weight is shifting, and then very quickly take the rudder from underneath. Drop. Okay, you good with that? Cool. Okay, so there's an impression of speed, there's an impression of we must hit the leg. I've kind of spoken about it already. If I move here, I'm going to check Tommy and I'm moving over here. My aim is to get Tommy on the ground. Now, again, don't go anywhere unless you really feel the need. Okay? When I drop, nothing happens. Okay? Essentially what I'm doing is this one. But if without hitting his leg, if I think of hitting his leg, that already makes it much easier to do. Because what I'm doing is starting that way to come back this way. Alright? So even if I don't hit that leg, I should be thinking of hitting that leg, which generates that downfall. Okay? After that then, kick and stand for them. point his nose, his fingers, whatever, you know. Job him with your penis, do something, okay? Defensively. So, from here, imports defensively. All right, so from here, once we get this position, once we get this, the next question is, okay, so visualization is go through the leg, but how do I actually hit that leg? Well, the trick is be ahead of the starting pistol. If I stand here and I go, I'm going to hit him in the leg, I'm going to hit him in the leg, I might just hit him in the leg. If I'm already, I've hit him in the leg. Go ahead of yourself. That is how we generate that speed. It's not me going, going to hit Tommy 15 times. You didn't see all 15? Because I'm that fast. Alright? But the point is to go from one position to the next. Once I hit here, once I hit here, once I hit. At any point, the reason you move that little bit faster is because you should have already been thinking in your head when you moved. Sounds a little kind of out there, but the point is you shouldn't be standing here going, I'm gonna hit Tommy. I've hit Tommy. I'm already there. Okay? So how does that work for the start of the technique? Well, I'm going to stand very planted like this, and Tommy fires a very quick punch. Because Tommy already told me that he tries to punch me in the face every time he does this. So can't you stand there slowly? That's it. The point is, I'm never standing on my heels, as we said. Structure comes from your heels, stability comes from your heels. So if you're going to go through this guy and you're going to go very quickly, you don't need that extra motion on here to here. You already need to be kind of already there. So even though I'm taking this from the side and ready to go, if this comes in, at this point, this is where I need to go very quickly. Already ahead of the game. So bear this in mind when you're doing any technique, you should not be starting from a neutral position. You should already be engaged. Not neutral as in stance neutral, neutral as in engine in neutral. Already be in first gear with the foot on the clutch and ready to go. Okay? You good with this? Moving on to the syllabus, this portion, two boys are going to do